Milk is a highly nutritive food. This makes it an ideal medium for the rapid multiplication of bacteria, especially under unhygienic production and storage at warm temperatures. A milk processor or handler will only be assured of the quality of raw milk if tests are carried out at various stages of production and transportation of the milk from the producer to the processor and finally to the consumer. Milk testing and control is an essential component of any milk processing industry, whether small, medium, or large scale. Milk is prone to adulteration due to its liquid nature. This may happen through addition of water by unfaithful persons from the point of production to the point of the consumer. Quality control, therefore, must begin at the farm. This is achieved through farmers using approved practices of milk production and handling and observation of laid-down rules on use of veterinary drugs on lactating animals and clean milk production and handling. Some of the tests carried out while assessing quality include checking for freshness, abnormalities, hygienic quality, physical characteristics, and if there are any illicit substances. Milk tests should be quick to perform, simple and easy to carry out, even by small-scale milk traders. They should be cheap, not wasteful on milk, and should provide accurate and reliable results. The Kenya Dairy Board is mandated to ensure all processors, including milk bars, obtain and serve quality milk. The Smallholder Dairy Commercialization Project, with the assistance of the Dairy Training Institute, has been training farmer groups and milk traders on some of the tests that we can carry out to determine the quality of milk.
The aspect that we are encouraging as a program is to ensure that the quality of milk from the farm level through the market chain up to the consumer is assured. Milk quality in a milk collection center like where we are today can be assured through making certain tests.
Now, the first and most important test you do in any dairy is the organoleptic test. The organoleptic test uses the five senses, or it can also be called the sensory evaluation. It uses the five senses in a human being. So when you get the milk to a dairy, you observe the cleanliness of the can. Is the can clean? So you can actually reject milk on the basis that the container is dirty. After you check the can, you shake the container to ensure that the milk inside is mixed. And then you open the can and
smell.
Okay, when you smell, you observe the smell of that milk. Does it have a cowy smell? Does it have an off smell from what you expect your milk to have? Clean milk should have a cowy smell. That is the smell of a clean cow. If the milk has an off smell, that is, it does not smell like milk, or it does not have a cowy smell, you can be able to detect the cause of that off smell. It could either be paint, it can also be either the animal was fed on the wrong kind of foodstuff, for example, onions, which the smell is actually felt in the milk. As you do that, you also feel the can to get the temperature. This tells you when the milk was milked, whether it is early in the morning, so it has cooled down, whether it has been refrigerated, or whether it is freshly milked, in which case it will be warm. After you do that, you also observe the color of the milk. We expect the color of this milk to be creamy white and to be clean. You also observe whether there are any extraneous matter in that milk. We want to check if there are any feedstuffs that have been left in the milk, whether the farmer actually sieved the milk. We want to check if there are maybe any insects that might have fallen in that milk or any other thing that is not supposed to be in the milk. Usually we expect our milk not to have any extraneous matter. We don't expect to find any feedstuffs or dusts covering our milk. So if the milk has, for example, insects or other kind of physical dirt, we usually reject that kind of milk. That is the first test we do in any dairy plant. So before any other test is done on the milk must be properly sampled. This ensures that all you get a representative sample of the milk that you're going to test. Now, normally when milk is left standing for a long time, the fats, which are lighter than the rest of the milk, usually come up. So unless proper sampling is done, then the results that will be obtained will be false results. Now, proper sampling can be done by first mixing all the milk in the can. So you stir your milk using a stirrer, and you stir properly to ensure that there is no fat layer on top of the milk. Then you use a stainless steel or aluminium scoop to get your sample of milk. You then take your milk to the sampling, to the testing area. If the milk is not to be tested immediately, the sample should be stored in a refrigerator at a temperature below 5°C to ensure that no further microbes grow in that milk until the time of testing. Our next test is the Cloton boiling test. This test is done to check whether milk can actually withstand heat treatment. Usually, if milk is from a cow that has mastitis, or from a cow that has colostrum, or milk that has stayed and has developed acidity may not actually withstand heat treatment. If heated, the milk usually clots. Now, for this test, you usually take a small sample of milk. It can be, you can use a spoon and a source of heat, which may be a candle. It can be a stove. It can be a jiko. You just take a small amount of milk from your sample and then heat it over a source of fire while shaking. You heat up to boiling point. And then observe. Once the milk boils, you observe the spoon. If there are any clots, then that milk is bad and should be rejected. If there are no clots, then the milk is good and can be accepted for processing. Okay, the next test is the ethanol test. It is an alternative to the Cloton boiling. It is actually more sensitive than Cloton boiling test. Usually the ethanol test tests the stability of the milk proteins and heat stability of the milk. Now, if milk has mastitis, it's from a cow that has mastitis or it has colostrum, or the milk has overstayed and has what we call developed acidity, usually that milk clots if mixed with an equal volume of ethanol. Now, the ethanol concentration depends on the quality that the processor wants for his milk. The minimum required or the minimum that is recommended is usually 68% to 70%, but processors can use up to 85%. Depending on the milk quality that they are targeting. Now, The procedure, we have this machine called the alcohol gun. We usually, after standardizing our ethanol, we put it inside the gun. And then it is calibrated such that it measures 2 mL of ethanol inside from this tube, while this other tube is put in the milk to measure the same volume, that is 2 mL of the milk. And then you mix, you can mix in a glass or in a petri dish. Now usually the procedure is you take the gun and then you measure, you put inside the inside your well mixed milk, and then you invert into a petri dish and then you shake. Now if there are clots on your plate, it shows that the milk is bad. If there are no clots, it shows that the milk is good. In case one does not have the ethanol gun, one can actually use syringes and take 2 mL of milk at 2 mL of the ethanol and then mix in a glass or petri dish. And then the results will be the same as if you had used an alcohol gun. Some traders put peroxide in their milk to preserve the milk, and this is not acceptable if the milk is to be used for fermentation because it may affect the fermentation process. Now, to test whether a farmer or a trader has put peroxide in their milk, we usually use peroxide strips. The strip has a part that is cream yellow in color, the top part. This is the part that is usually dipped in milk. Once you dip this part in milk, if it comes out the same color, then that milk does not have peroxide. If it changes color to blue or greenish blue, then that milk has peroxide. The lactometer test measures the density of milk. Normal milk should have a density of between 1.028 to 1.032. If your milk or the milk tested has a density lower than 1.028, that milk has been adulterated with water. If the milk has a density that is higher than 1.032, that milk has been adulterated with solids that add to the density. The lactometer is calibrated in lactometer degrees. From the top, we have 0 all the way up to 40 at the very bottom. To test the density of milk, you take your sample of milk, which is thoroughly mixed, and then you insert your lactometer, and then let it sink, and then float, and stabilize on its own. Then you take the reading, you just read where the level of the milk is, and then you read at that point. For example, this one has a reading of 1.029. So this shows that this is good milk. If you put a lactometer in water, the reading will be 0 because the density of water is 1. Therefore, if you add water into your milk, the density goes below the recommended density. For example, this sample we had put water earlier. So if you put in the